Alright, I want to show you what I picked up at Kmart today. Doing some nosing around. I've looked at these before, and they're $2.49, and I didn't know if I want to pay that much for it. Something I don't know if it's going to work or not. But today I scanned it just for the heck of it, and it came up $1.50, and I said, well, for $1.50, can't go too wrong. But that's why I can't believe it. I don't know if you can see that. It says it's 24-ounce capacity. If that's the case, well, you could do your 2 cups of water for your meal and then have enough over for something to drink. It's about four inches wide, about 4 inches tall, and the base is 4 inches. And it says here, rolled rim, heavy duty, glazed enamel on steel. So anyway, I'm gonna see how it does and boil a couple cups of water. So anyway, get back to you in a bit. Hey folks, out here in the shack again, and I want to show you my tuna can stove. I've had it for a while, been playing with it, and I'm torn between whether I like it or not. Does a great flame, water in about 4.5 minutes, 2 cups of water. But I want to show it to you today. It's a tuna can, and you make your little church key indentions there along the bottom. Then on the bottom there we have a potted meat can, and it's got holes cut out into it. If you see that in there, got holes at the top of it, so the airflow comes through here, can't go nowhere, so it enters through the hose and it produces a big tall flame. So let me get set up here, and I want to do two things. I want to show y'all the stove and then my new pot that I got at Kmart there. Boil a couple cups of water. Be back in a minute. Okay, folks. I got a little tin here, tin top for a priming pan. I got 1 ounce of alcohol. That's about all it's going to hold. A buddy of me tried one time, put 2 ounces in it, she come everywhere. So I just poured 2 cups of water into my Kmart cup. And starting at 57 degrees. And let me get her primed here. There we go. I think I got her. Is she primed? Okay, she's a hot gun. So let me give her a minute here to start up there. Now she's going. Alright. Get her over here. Get her on there. We'll start the timer. There we go. All right. Now I don't have a top yet. Might have Kenny building one. I don't know if he will or not. But anyway, she didn't slid down in there. That's why it's freezing. There we go. Now she's on there. All right. Okay. I'm gonna turn the camera off. Ooh, look at there. She's calmed down. Anyway, I'll turn the camera off till she gets, say, 200, turn her back on. That way you won't have to watch the boil. Anyway, be right back to you. Well, while we're waiting, I thought I turn the center light off, give you maybe a little shot of that flame down there. Don't look too bad. Spreads out pretty good. Anyway, get back to you. Get closer to 212. Alright, 201. 203. 205. I'm trying to watch the timer, because it only counts down, so I'll have to do the math. Let me turn it off there. 2433. I don't know if y'all can see that or not. No, you can't see it, can you? Well, she's a boiling. And it's a good boil, too. I mean, it's quite good, isn't it? So 2433, you can take that out now. And we'll get her off there. Oh man, she's gonna be. Whew, look at that. And there's that flame. You can see that flame now, I guess. Maybe you can't. Let me scoot her back a little bit there. And she's out. She is out already. 2340. Write that down, folks.